In the midst of the COVID-19 pandemic, the South African government has called for a 21-day lockdown whereby residents should stay home as much as possible. In Inova Park, though, a high-crime area on the Cape Flats, children can still be found playing in the streets. Here, many low-income families live in cramped spaces and survive from hand to mouth, and without their source of income, this lockdown could have dire consequences.
The vibe here, it's not so good because we can't go out to the shops to go buy something for us to eat. We have to remain in the house with my children and my grandchildren and my great-grandchildren.
Anthony and Evelyn Williams live in Hanover Park. After having a stroke, Anthony is unable to speak and has trouble walking. Because of the transport restrictions, it will be difficult for Evelyn to get her husband to the hospital or collect his medication. Sadika Kasim stays on Evelyn's property in a two-bedroom window house. She is married and has four children, and they all live together. For their family, the lockdown has been difficult.
I have a child who's asthmatic, and as you can see, I don't even have windows. And when he gets sick, I must take him outside so he can breathe. I can't even take him to the day hospital to go under vaccine for his chest to open. So I really don't know what we're going to do in this lockdown if my child gets sick.
For the longest time, Nova Park has had an issue with gangsterism. And even though there are more police patrolling now, Sadika and her family still lives in fear.
The people steal our stuff through the windows. The gangsters walk around. The shooting. Once they shoot through my window house, my eldest daughter was standing in the kitchen with her sister. She was making tea. If she didn't duck in time, that bullet were through her head.
Together, the families of both Sadika and Evelyn consists of 12 people, and these are the cramped streets that they stay in.
Some of our communities are living in backyards, they are living in wendy houses, like a 4x4, 3x4 wendy house, where there's about 8 people in the wendy house, and this wendy house stands in the yard of another group of people that has got semi-detached homes. That has also got 10 or 12 people in the house. So if you look at that congestion already, and then it becomes difficult for social distancing. And I will look at the area where the kids need to go. The people are complaining, kids are playing outside. But for these kids to be inside is difficult. And then you've got the block of flats where 60 families stay in 100 square meter. And those kids need to come out and to play, and their parents need to go shopping. And I think the difficult part for them is a lot of their parents still need to go work. And these kids are at home, out of school, and nobody's obviously managing them. There's no overseers for them. So these parents are not part of those people that can say, now I'm in lockdown and I can stay at home. Because for them it is no work, no pay. Whenever it changes, people need to be educated. And this takes time. Because you don't have the infrastructure, you don't have the volunteers, you don't have the manpower really to do it like this. But for the more privileged people, I would see when it's on the news, they get the news, they tell their children, they act immediately. And then they ask themselves, why don't they call it these people? Why don't they comply? But it takes these people some time to get the information, you know?
With laws changing daily, Craven says that physical public education, loud hailing, and the mobilizing of communities are what's needed to update people.
The density of this community is a problem that we really have to look in. Lockdown really for this community, chasing them back into their homes, into the yards, it's very complicated.